Hello and welcome again to What Tactics. Right, we are on the Su-85 once again, the TF-5 Russian tank destroyer, and we're on Karelia, which not only is a map I very much like, but also it's one that's perfectly suited to tank destroyers, and therefore the Su-85 in particular. We're on the north side, which actually allows a little bit more leverage on sniping, and there's my luck straight away. A crazy scout, obviously without sixth sense. But even if he had sixth sense, it doesn't seem to be much of an issue for him. He just carries on regardless, even though he's been spotted and shot at. Okay, so he's dead. You know, we'll resume our positioning on our preferred location, which is near these rocks. They give a very good vision on this flank here, but they also give a good vision on this side, and there's also a rock next to it, as you can see here, which can give you some cover in case you get spotted. Now it looks like I'm firing at nobody, but I'm actually what I'm doing in the game, I'm actually lining up my gun with the position, the recorded position of those enemy tanks there, and just taking a few pot shots. Even if I don't hit them or deal any damage, it's just good to kind of keep the enemy a bit on their toes and slow them down a little bit to allow my teammates to position themselves better. After that Panzer 38 TNA did that kind of walk of death in the middle of the map, it doesn't seem like any of the enemies want to do the same, so we have to kind of alternate between left and right side to see if we have any opportunity of spotting, and there's not really that many, so we're just gonna fast forward a little bit. I'm gonna try and fire here from a fair distance, but not without much luck. Game is not going very well. HP count is in favor of the enemy, but finally we get a target, and it's incredible how they just don't react. You know, I mean, seek cover, I don't know, reverse, do something. Well, anyway, I don't complain, and now there's a Su-100, which is a very good target for me, because that's a dangerous tank. They do go pretty fast. He's exposing his side, so it's an easier hit for me. Now he's looking at me, I should really back off now. Why am I not backing off? I don't know. I lost a fair amount of HP, but then he just gave up. I don't understand these people. Alright, okay. it did cost me a bit of HP, that, but you know, I killed another enemy, and a dangerous one for that matter. So what have we got? We've actually got a situation that's a bit strange. I mean, look at that archer there on the minimap. All alone as a tank destroyer. I mean, come on. I mean, I'd understand maybe if you were a scout, or even a heavy tank, but as a tank destroyer going that far, completely detached from the team, well, that means that the left side is completely empty, because look, I mean, there's no way you can spot anybody, and he can just about spot that KV-1 coming, and there's also an OIXP which are also coming, and I knew that, I could see that before, so I already made my move, and I'm going here and I'm going to do a bit of defense, and let's see if we can penetrate this one. We should be able to.
That one didn't go through.
All right, that didn't go through, but this one should.
Penetration.
And so should this one, if we can reload in time.
Got him.
Perfect. Okay, so that's one threat, but look at that team. Isn't that appalling? I mean, you know, we've got basically half the HP of our team, of the enemy team, and that archer is still doing, I'm not sure what. So there's this KV-1, the BDR doesn't seem to be able to deal with it, so I'm gonna have to go and help. I was just basically just trying to assess whether he was behind a tree or not, and he wasn't, he's actually behind the rock, so I gotta go a fair long way to try and get his back, but this should be an easy prey. Okay, that's four kills. But especially, we've gotten rid of this threat on the right flank of our layout. The archer is still engaging in this duel at the enemy base with the Su-85. I don't think much is going to come out from that. I'm more concerned with that OI, which has already got 3 kills, and is coming up from that side. And as expected, the archer died. I mean, what can you do alone as a tank destroyer? Anyway, that left player is a good player. Already 2 kills, and one of them was actually the OI. I mean, well done. Thanks to you, mate, because that would have been a big threat. So what have we got to do here? Well, we're all bunched up at the base, but the enemy is also down in numbers. So I elect to kind of sit there and wait, just in case there's any more stray enemies that are willing to come up. I've got half my HP, so I can't be too cocky, I can't be too daring. I gotta play defensively. I'm also very worried about the Su-100, because, you know, one shot from him and I'm dead. So I'm not going to go and ask for trouble. I'm not going to go and, wander around the map. I'm just going to sit here and see if anybody wants to, you know, is going to pop up from behind that rock and actually is, you know, willing to engage near our base. The BDR has finally made the move. I don't know if it's a very good idea, because the BDR doesn't actually have that much armor. I mean, it's okay, but... there you go. A bishop. All right. Okay, all right, well, that's all right. You know, he thought he could attack with an artillery. Okay, let him do it. So that's 5 kills for me, but especially it's 1 artillery less for the enemy. But I'm still very worried about this Su-100, which also has not yet been spotted, which means it's either a big camper, as they say, or a very good player who knows how to play with a tank destroyer. That left is... seems to be doing the same as the bishop, that is to kind of take a move and follow that BDR, which has actually gone a fair long way. But I'm sorry, I'm more concerned with this side, because I reckon that's where it's more likely that we will get the threat, because it's a bit more open, and what a tank destroyer we would prefer. Slightly more open, with a few more hiding places, a bit more vegetation, rather than the big valley, the big corridor that you get on this side here. So I'm just going to fast forward a little. Oh, what's going on? So somebody's capping the base. It could be the Su-85, it could be the Su-100. What is amazing is that he actually went completely unspotted. I mean, whoever it is was never spotted by me, by the BDR, or by the left. So where did he come from? Anyway, that's not really the issue. The issue here now is to defend base. So here is the Su-100. That's the player I really, really fear. But there's first, we have got to deal with this base capture. So I'm going to deal with that first, the Su-100 later, because also I've got the high ground. And look at that. The Su-85 has got rid of our heavy tank. Okay, right. So it's just us, me, with 6 kills and the Su-100. I'm just aiming at random here, just in case it's still lurking in there somewhere, and I'm hoping to maybe just take his health down a little bit, just enough so that I only need one shot to kill him, because he also can kill me in one shot. And what do I do here? Rather than wait right at the top, I actually decide to do a bit of flanking. He knows I'm at the base, because I've been spotted, obviously. So I'm going to move away from that, let him think that I'm up there, and if he's thinking about taking evasive action coming up from another side, or if he wants to just approach me from the middle, frontally, I can surprise him. But he doesn't come up. And where is the left? What's the left doing? It's very, very gently edging right there, as you can see, along there, and he spots the Su-100, and damn, I'm too far away, really far away. Oh, this is difficult. So I'm kind of thinking whether to go from the top or whether to go from the side. So I like to go from the top, because at least I have a bit of high ground. But surprisingly, not only the Lef is still at full health, but he's pounding the Su-100. He's literally pounding him.
Target acquired.
Okay, let's see if I can get him.
Where'd they go?
Wow. Okay. Well, well done, Lef. Three kills. But good game on this Su-85. We've done good damage. And we got a Stanker, which was something that was missing from this tank, so I'm quite pleased with that. The Su-85 is a good tank destroyer, is mobile enough, it's got good camouflage, it's got a very good gun, and I look forward to more battles in this tank. So thank you very much for watching.